Namaskaram. Welcome back to Him Talks. Right now we have Mr. Ganesh Balakrishnan Garu, who is one of the most eminent and prophetic personalities in our chartered accountant fraternity. And he's a partner with Deloitte, and he has a lot of insights for the next generation. So we are here to know about his typical day. Sir, how does your typical day look like?
So typical day, if you were to start, I start my day early.
Yes, sir.
So I start about 4:30 in the morning.
Yes, sir.
So I have got a lot of time. And I close it out by 10 o'clock, unless if there are any deadlines, which generally goes long. Otherwise, my day starts with as early as 4:30. And the first thing which I do it is do my own messaging, so that which reflects the start of the day to be more positive.
Yes, sir. In a given professional day, how relevant is your CA course? Like we have studied a lot of subjects, so most of them complain that they are not exactly relevant in what we are doing. And what is the case with you?
So I would say that when I've joined, the CA course itself, and whatever I've learned in the CA course, they are very, very relevant. So I don't know how many people have thought it's not relevant. It is relevant. The reason why people believe that it is not relevant is because you don't apply the concepts. You only learn these concepts to pass an exam.
Yes.
So I think the day when you learn the concepts, everything is relevant. Whether it's an audit, whether it's a tax, whether it's an IT, whether it's any course, you are exposed to various learnings. The only gap which I find these days is people do not upgrade themselves because they just learn. Having passed a CA doesn't mean that you know everything.
Absolutely, sir.
You need to keep upgrading it very, very often.
And what is that thing which you love the most about your day? And what is that one thing you might prefer to change?
I would say that what I love most is being relevant.
Okay.
And what do I want to change? I don't want to feel any day to be bored. So I never get myself bored.
Yes,
unless I upbring myself and say, hey, listen, I look a day positive.
Yes,
and
sir.
There is never a dull moment in life. So if you really ask me what I have to change, nothing.
Okay.
But is there anything to change? The answer is yes, because there's more things to learn. So what I don't really get time many times is to spend more on learning.
Absolutely.
So that is something which I have to start doing it.
Sir, and if Elon Musk builds a time machine for us, and if you are to become a CA fresher once again, so how would you start it? Which career option would you be choosing if you are, qualifying in 2020?
So if I were to start today, I would say focus will be more on technology.
Okay.
Focus is more on economic affairs. So the economics is the area where I would want to do it, because what's happening today is there is a gap between what you earn and what is being spent, whether it's at a nation level, it's a per capita, with the disparities in income. I would say I would love to do more economics.
Yes, sir.
Because that's much more interesting and also gives a lot of value to a nation.
Yes, sir. Sir, and we are doing this recording in the context of CA practice, and we always have the big four of the CA practice, the traditional practice setup. So where is this particular ecosystem going forward? And is there any disparity in how fast the big four are growing and how exactly the traditional practice system is going? So what's your say on this? And for an youngster, what is your piece of advice here?
So if I were to put this way, whether it's a big four or a non-big four, I really would not put it. If you were to look at it, the maximum number of people who are very successful in tax are the individual practitioners.
Absolutely.
So the question is about, one, the knowledge one possesses, two, the availability of capital, which is very, very important, three, the adaptability of technology, which is right now not, see, you could get a technology adapted faster because you got exposed to various other opportunities outside of India. And that's the reason why you find. But I think if a person is really capable, right, he will be much, much more successful than your own self of saying that, you know, worked for an organization. But as I said, evolving is that there is nothing called somebody big, somebody small. Everything is evolving. And my take is that if for any of these fresher chartered accountants, invest your time in learning, not in earning.
Yes,
unfortunately, today everybody says I want 8 lakhs, 10 lakhs, 15 lakhs. Not invest in learning. Once you learn, money will follow it.
Absolutely, sir.
So that's what my advice to all the young chartered accountants would be there.
Yes, sir. And for all the freshly qualified chartered accountants, this is a wonderful opportunity because sir has just consented to help you all out for a 6-hour session in the second or third week of February. The date will be out soon. So you can actually come and learn where exactly you should be starting your career. And this is coming from decades of industry experience. And also we'll talk about power dressing, because if you look at him, he's always dressed up to the occasion. And you'll also talk about some intricacy aspects which you wouldn't learn otherwise in your books or academies, because this is out of your professional and his personal experience altogether. And we will keep you posted, so stay tuned. So this is CA Himakant from Him Talks, and we would like to thank Ganesh Balakrishnan Garu for his fantastic time and thought throughout.
Thank you very much.
So thank you very much, and we'll keep you posted about the course. Thank you.